Listen,
Thank you, sir.
Girishankar,
Yes, sir.
Tell me something about yourself.
Sir, my name is Girishankar. I come from Chennai, Tamil Nadu, sir. I've done my undergraduation in dentistry. My father's name is Mr. S. Raghunathan, and my mother's name is Mrs. M. Vatsala. Both of them are retired employees from BSNL, sir.
No, having done the BDS, you had done 2014. What you have been doing since then?
Sir, I've been giving civil service exams, sir. I cleared in 2015 and again in...
Are you working now?
No, sir. I have an issue going on, sir, regarding my OBC status. So I'm pursuing that case right now, sir.
So you're not practicing or doing anything on dental?
Yes, sir. I'm practicing dentistry on a part-time basis.
Okay. 2014, I think, you know, this BDS 4 years course?
It's a 5 years course.
5 years course. And you know all these things, I think the government would have spent, you would have spent. After investing so much, don't you think it's such a waste, really?
Sir, I don't think it is a waste as such, sir. But I feel that in dentistry, there is comparatively less scope for me to serve, sir. So I feel being a part of the civil service, I will be having a larger scope to serve, sir.
When you thought of, you know, going for civil services? After BDS or before that?
Sir, after BDS, sir.
I see. So you were, what really attracted you to civil services?
Sir, initially it was during my college second year, sir, that one of my college seniors had cleared the civil service examinations. So at that time I got to know about the exams and I studied about the civil service exams, sir. I was majorly attracted by three factors, sir. One is that the various diversity that is available in civil services, sir. Second is the social recognition that is there with the job of a civil servant, sir. And thirdly is also the job satisfaction that comes with civil service.
Out of these three, you are attracted by number two?
Sir, by number one, I would say, sir, by the diversity that is available in civil service.
Okay. But generally you see, in general, in India,
yes, sir.
What people perceive of IAS officer or a bureaucracy in general, but specifically for IAS, what people perceive about IAS, INS officer, any, in general?
Sir,
don't take Tamil Nadu only the case.
Yes. Sir, general perception is that they see the post of an IAS officer as having a very high...
Is it positive or negative?
Sir, it is largely positive, sir.
Okay.
Sir, because they see IAS officer as a person to whom they can go for their problems and from whom they can get the issue resolved, sir. So, in that way, they see it from a positive perspective, sir.
Negative?
Sir, negative is that they see it slightly from an... there is a slight apprehension whether they can go and approach the IAS officer for their issue because they see it to be a very higher level post, so they have this apprehension whether they can directly go and approach an IAS officer to get their issues resolved.
Okay, so having, you know, from the, you know, done that BDS course and all that, let me understand that, are you really following it up, you know, on various on health journals or something? No.
No, sir, I'm not following.
You are just not following. No, okay. At least the government health scheme?
Yes, sir, health scheme I've been following, sir.
Name anyone which you feel is one of the best government of India schemes related with the health sector.
Sir, I would say the current scheme, sir, of Ayushman Bharat scheme, which has recently been created.
Okay.
That is a very good initiative to provide healthcare insurance to people, sir. So that I would rate as a very good health scheme.
Explain a little bit about Ayushman Bharat.
Sir, Ayushman Bharat has two major verticals, sir. The first is the National Health Protection Scheme, which seeks to provide 5 lakh insurance to the families per year, sir. And second is the health and wellness approach, sir, wherein they want to upgrade the primary health care centers to health and wellness centers. So they want to focus more on the preventive aspect of disease in the health and wellness approach.
Why still some of the states have not really opted for the Bharatman this scheme, particularly some states have still not opted. They said we don't want, we want our own schemes.
Yes, sir.
Can you name any such states?
Sir, I'm not aware of the states that have not
okay.
opted. Sir, I think the reason would be that maybe the states have a better scheme to provide health insurance, sir.
Okay.
And also there is a reason that the states have to contribute 40% of the funds for this particular scheme, sir, as it is a centrally sponsored scheme. So certain states have a feeling that their funds are being tied up for this purpose and so they might not opt for the scheme, sir.
Okay. let's come to a related subject, not on the schemes. What is happening really? Coronavirus, actually.
Sir, currently...
I'm not going to ask you, you know, doctor, I want to know what is going to be impact, or likely impact on the Indian economy, actually.
Sir, one is that Indian economy is it is attached to China in terms of supply chain, sir. So any disruption in supply chain
asked
in China.
About Delhi, right?
Sorry?
You asked about Delhi and right. Connected, right?
No, I'm saying Indian economy. Yeah, please continue.
Sir, so Indian economy is connected to Chinese economy, sir, in terms of supply chain. So, and lot of raw materials and initial products are imported from China to India, sir, for further processing and export. So those would be affected, sir. Those industries would be heavily affected, sir. For example, the pharmaceutical industry, which heavily relies on Chinese active pharmaceutical ingredients, is facing certain shortfall in shortage of resources, sir.
Okay.
Similarly, even the diamond cutting industry of Surat is also facing problems because export markets of Hong Kong is getting affected, sir, due to coronavirus.
I think something has happened yesterday all over the world and Indian markets also. Something has, you know, very, very striking happened. Have you seen any today's newspaper?
Yes, sir. There is a crash in the stock market, sir.
Yeah.
All across the world. It is majorly on fears of recession or a global recession due to coronavirus outbreaks.
Have you opted for foreign service also?
Yes, sir.
Tell me significant outcome of Trump visit in India.
Sir, one, in terms of defense sector, India has signed certain agreements to import weapons from the United States, sir. That will help in boosting the defense.
Name anyone.
Sir, we have signed deals for two helicopters, sir. One is the Apache 22 helicopter and other is the MH-60R helicopter, sir.
What is the difference between the two?
Sir, the Apache helicopter is being procured for use in army, sir. And the MH-60R helicopter is being procured for deployment in naval vessels, sir, as a frontline helicopter.
This Trump visit was more or less political in nature or it was really having some substance?
Sir, it did have substance, sir, because we have signed deals relating to defense sector, energy sector, sir. But it was also, it is also being perceived as having political impact, sir. Because
what is the deal on energy sector?
Sir, India has initiated talks to import more oil from the United States, sir, as a replacement for oil that we are importing from the Gulf nations to diversify our imports.
Yes.
You are interested in turtle walk.
Yes.
So what do you do as part of that?
Sir, in turtle walk, during the night times from the month of January end to March end, we walk along the beach, sir, along the Chennai coast, and we collect turtle eggs, sir, which are laid by Olive Ridley turtles. And it is transferred to a hatchery, sir, where it is hatched and then released into the sea after it is hatched.
You work along with some organization or?
Yes, sir, along with organization, sir. It is the Student Sea Turtle Conservation Network, sir, in Chennai.
Yeah. So it happens throughout the year or in a particular period?
Sir, it happens between January end to March, sir.
Okay.
To March end, sir.
And you release the turtles to the sea?
Sir, that is taken care by Forest Department, sir. They maintain the hatchery and they release the turtles into sea.
We spend a large part of our time in school and colleges as part of our education.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you are given an opportunity for revamping our education system,
yes, sir.
What are the primary or important changes that you think we need to bring in?
Sir, one in education sector, I feel there should be more of practical work, sir, compared to the theoretical part. Theoretical part should be given its due weightage, sir, but along with that, practical part also should be given more weightage, sir. Secondly, the application of whatever is being taught in school, that part also has to be emphasized, sir. Rather than only focusing on the theoretical aspect, we should also focus on what are the possible applications of this particular thing, sir. And thirdly, we should also focus on the physical fitness of students, sir, not just focusing on the education aspect, but also the physical fitness aspect of students.
There are people who suggest that to bring about social change, well, education course, literacy, or just take it case of literacy. Literacy is very important. Do you think that literacy is a key factor in social change?
Yes, sir. Literacy is definitely a key factor, sir. So, having this ability to read and comprehend what is given in a material is important for them to form their own opinions, sir, and then to bring about social change.
Awesome, sir.
Hi, Girish. You have done your bachelor's in dental surgery. Why is the dental aspects or the surgeries not included in the insurance, health insurance?
Ma'am, till now it was not included, ma'am. But recently, in the past 5 years, we are seeing inclusion of dental healthcare also into health insurance, ma'am.
Why it has been included now?
Ma'am, now it is being included because of increasing awareness among people regarding the importance of dental healthcare. And also, the expenditure on aesthetic aspect of dentistry is also increasing in the recent times. So, because of these factors, the dental healthcare has also got its place in the health insurance.
So, which is better managed in India, by the regular health insurance or the life insurance or the non-life insurance? According to you, we are more concerned as a public or a private sector, which is more taken care.
Sorry, ma'am, I'm not.
You're not aware of it. And as a doctor, I want you to shed some light of difference between an epidemic and a pandemic.
Ma'am, epidemic is a particular disease which is seen at a higher frequency in the region where it is usually seen. But pandemic is when it spreads to areas outside where it is usually not, where it is usually seen. So, pandemic is more like a global, widespread, wide geographical presence, whereas epidemic is restricted to that particular area, but at a higher frequency.
Okay, so coronavirus falls under the category of?
Ma'am, till now it has not been declared as a pandemic.
It has been.
Sorry, thank you.
You are from CBSE, Philip, a student, so how was KV and Navodaya different? And there has been a huge agitation in Tamil Nadu of not introducing Navodaya school. So why is it so?
Ma'am, I'm not aware of the difference between KV and Navodaya school.
Okay. So have you heard of this agitations against Navodaya entering into Tamil Nadu?
No, ma'am. I'm not aware.
This is a hot topic happening politically. And have you heard of happiness index?
Yes,
can you shed some light on that?
Yes, ma'am. And the world happiness index is released by the United Nations. So here countries are ranked according to the happiness that people perceive themselves to be having, ma'am. So it is based on various parameters, ma'am. So the first one is the social capital that is present in the country, the perceived feeling of people to have someone to rely upon. Then second, it also depends upon the freedom that they have, the perceived freedom that they have in pursuing what they want to do. And it also depends on the literacy rate and also on the per capita income that they are earning.
So what is lacking in India? The categories which you specified, what are we lacking by? Which is pushing us way below in the ranking?
Ma'am, I think our income levels will be low, ma'am.
That's the only category because of which we are falling.
Not because of only that, ma'am. Our income levels, our literacy levels, in all aspects, we have to comprehensively improve.
Which country is ranking on top, right?
No? Ma'am, right now, Finland has been ranked one, ma'am, the current World Happiness Report.
Finland. In India, which state?
Ma'am, I'm not aware of which state in India is ranked first.
Please do check whether it is Finland. And it's also not only the economic and the social aspects, environmental aspects are also linked with the happiness index of how much your tree or the green cover is.
Okay.
That's also linked.
You know, the UN has now redefined health to include well-being as well, right?
Yes, ma'am.
She was talking about the happiness.
Yes, ma'am.
And so what does well-being cover more than perhaps health on one side? And I think you also mentioned something which is very important, which is perceived freedom.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't remember which country, but perhaps one of those East European countries, there was this lady who was raped at a young age.
Okay.
And, as a result, the trauma led her to depression for a long time. Finally, she argued that she should end her life. And interestingly, the court allowed her to end her life. So would you consider this as perceived freedom? So can someone be free by deciding to end their life just because of the traumatic conditions they undergo and they don't perceive any meaning in life on one side? And on the other side, we have a new definition for health, which includes well-being. Apparently that includes psychological well-being.
Yes, sir.
So are we at loggerheads in considering these two aspects, which is freedom to understand what one's life is, and the other is to perceive a global health, which includes perhaps, I don't know, limited choice making.
Ma'am, I feel the person should have the right to end their lives in certain cases, ma'am, under which it is defined by law. But I think for people who have been disturbed on a psychological basis, they would not be in a proper frame of mind to decide whether to take their life, ma'am. For such persons, we have to provide mental health care services. We have to try to improve them to come out of the psychological state, ma'am. So in that way, I feel the perceived freedom should not go to the extent of ending one's life in the absence of any infirmity, ma'am, that disables them.
I just wanted to ask you, connected to that, you said that someone who is mentally challenged cannot decide or is not equipped to decide whether to end his or her life, but another person perhaps is normal. So what is the difference between normality and disability for mind? Who decides? Is it decided completely by DSM? Do you believe that the DSM includes all human capabilities, human dispositions of the mind? You know what's the DSM, right?
Sorry, ma'am. I'm not aware.
I think you can later check what's the DSM. The whole field of psychiatry and psychology follows DSM.
Okay. Ma'am, pardon me if I had said that, ma'am. Actually, I didn't mean mentally challenged people, ma'am, but they would not be in a proper state of mind, ma'am. For example, some person who's been suffering from a debilitating condition for a very long period of time, he might be in a certainly disturbed state of mind, ma'am. So at that stage, he should not be given the right to make...
Do you think that people who have contributed to this world in many disciplines like science, they were all very healthy? A lot of people who are mentally challenged have contributed a whole huge lot.
Yes, ma'am.
One very famous example, because it also kind of portrayed in the movie of the beautiful mind, A Beautiful Mind. You know whom I'm talking about, right?
No, ma'am.
John.
Okay.
Who was schizophrenic.
Okay.
So who always lived with delusions, but then he contributed a lot to the field of mathematics.
Yes, ma'am, that way we cannot write off anyone for their infirmities, ma'am. But in certain cases, I meant they would not be in a right state of mind to make decisions. For that time, we should try to provide that help that will enable them to take the right choice.
Right.
And hello, Mr. Girishankar. I think you are confident enough to take UPSC interview.
Yes, sir.
How confident you are?
Sir, I'm very confident to take the UPSC examination.
Oh, define that very confident.
Sir, very confident in the sense I'm confident enough to properly address the questions that are being placed to me by the board, as well as to express my positives to the board so as to, for them to select me, sir.
So, are you now properly expressing yourself to the board?
Sir, for some questions I've not been able to properly express, sir. For other questions I'm trying my best to express.
Okay. And since your father and mother both are working in PSU, BSNL.
Yes,
so in the, when 1947, when our independence came, there was a debate between PSU, existence of PSU and private sector.
Yes,
now things have changed. And what do you think about that debate, and what is your take on PSU versus private sector? Who will propel India's economy towards the growth and development?
Sir, I feel there are certain sectors where the public sector has to take the where the market mechanism is not sufficient to address all the needs of the society, sir. In those sections, public sector has to take care, sir. But in the remaining sectors, wherever we can liberalize, private sector will have to be allowed so as to take the lead in promoting the economy as well as that sector, sir.
Okay. What is your take on government's decision on Air India?
Sir, Air India definitely has to be disinvested, sir, so that the health of the airline industry, the health of the company is increasing, sir, and also it increases the competition in the airlines.
Okay. So, if you are placed at the disposal of BSNL,
yes, sir,
what would you decide, knowing its condition and its loss-making
yes, sir,
graph also we have been observing for past 2 decades. So, yes, what will be your decision on BSNL now?
Sir, BSNL also I feel should be disinvested largely, sir, because the private sector has largely taken up the role in providing telecommunication service, sir. But in certain areas, as the telecommunication minister has mentioned, BSNL is providing strategic telecommunication network, like for the army as well as for the armed forces, other forces.
Which one you are using?
Sir?
Which one you are using?
Sir, I am using Airtel, sir.
So what, if you are saying the Airtel, what comes in your mind immediately now?
Sir, for Airtel, sir.
Yeah. Suppose you have been using Vodafone, then what comes in your mind?
Sir, the previous Hutch Dog advertisement comes to my mind, sir.
So, okay. Yeah, please.
Thank you, sir. And I just want to know your opinion on One Nation, One Ration Card.
Sir, I feel the One Nation, One Ration Card policy has to be implemented, sir, because it has certain positives like providing public distribution system benefits to migrant laborers who come from one state to another, sir. So, in that way, I feel the card should be implemented, but states should be adequately provided with supplies so as to ensure that their resources are not spread very thinly, sir. The extra resources for accommodating migrant laborers will also have to be metered in, and they have to be provided with provisions.
So, don't you think the local population will agitate because it is an impact on their own resources, what they are going to
yes.
do? But don't you think it will lead to law and order situation or anything like this CAA protest or something like that?
Sir, definitely the local population has been raising their voice, sir. For example, even in Tamil Nadu, certain sections have been expressing opinion about the One Nation, One Card policy, sir. But we have to take that section of society along, sir. We should take them into confidence.
The TN has agreed for this or they are still not agreed?
Sir, Tamil Nadu has not agreed, sir, for the policy.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Please check again.
Yeah,
that will be a news.
Okay. Yeah.
Just last
piece.
So, what was your subject domains?
It was anthropology. So
anthropology. Okay. In lieu of this CAA protest and what has been going on, I just want to know the link between the citizenship, because we are a nation state. Okay. So, nations of citizenship and the tribal identity. I just want to draw a link. I just want you to draw a link between these two.
Sir, tribal identity is how the tribes identify themselves, sir. It is a cultural identity, sir, the tribal identity as such, whereas citizenship is a administrative identity that is provided by the state, sir. So, in certain cases, there is a conflict between tribal identity and between the administrative identity that is provided, sir.
So, which one do you support?
Sir, I would support the administrative identity to be more authentic, sir.
Okay, if I am, for example, I am Irula tribe and I am calling myself Irula and you are a district collector sitting as a district collector, you want them to be identify themselves as an Indian or maybe Indian, yes, obviously. So, if they want Irula and you are imposing Indian, so this creates an issue, right?
Yes, sir.
I want to know, like, more...
Sir, we should not be imposing only the identity of Indian on the tribal population, sir. Whatever identity that they are promoting for themselves as with their community name, that also has to be embraced, sir. But for the purpose of administration, we should go ahead with the administrative identity that is provided to them, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
We'll call you, huh? Sit down, please. This is your first mock interview or attended your mock interviews?
Sir, I've attended one mock interview, sir, last week.
You attended?
Yes.
When you interviewed it?
Sir, it is on March 19th, sir.
Those times there. Okay, you tell me how you performed in this mock interview.
Sir, I performed okay, sir, but I didn't perform very well, sir.
What was the last one?
Ma'am, last one was also on the same lines.
Same?
Yes, sir.
Now, two opportunities are given. You just listed out your own weakness and strength actually. This is only to help you out.
Yes, sir. One, I have to improve my voice.
Okay.
I feel when I'm answering, my voice is going down, sir.
Okay.
And secondly, for the questions for which I do not know the answer, for that also my voice is going very low, sir.
Okay, there's one. Next.
Sir, next, I feel I should be more updated with what is going in the current event, sir.
Okay. Next one.
Sir, these two are...
Okay, strengths.
Sir, strengths, I feel I'm able to...
Smiling, huh? Okay.
Sir, I would say I'm able to express to an extent what my opinion is on a particular issue.
Okay. Fine. So, actually, whatever you said, by and large is correct, both strength and weakness is also correct. I think you started the interview, I think I have to really tell you actually. It only is just so that you can improve. The blunder you did it the moment you came, you never wished to anyone. That is totally unpardonable. This is the first impression and you are looking lost actually. Of course, there will not be much problem for them to you to enter and sit and all that. But suppose, his journey looks like that is not only your face in the interview, it means also shows that probably in a unknown situation, you also, how you will react, that is also one thing being checked actually. So you are looking lost. Second, I mean general observation which I thought I should tell you, you are not very mentally prepared. And you take initializing, you answering the question, you take little bit time, initial time, you are a little confused and nervous. Once you start speaking, you are much more confident at that point in time.
Okay, sir.
Probably I think you have to think that you are going for interview is really important.
Mm.
And you have come up to this stage, you are good.
Yes.
But not like answering like when he asked how confident. You should not be artificially speaking. When you started with the bang and all, then said no, some question I was not able to answer. Probably I think could have been a little more moderated answer. What is your feeling?
Yes, sir, same.
Little more moderated answer would have been there. Of course, this is a surprise question. Could be asked sometime, you know. Since you have seen this, why it was asked since you have done BDS 2014. Even I think that first part, that why you have government has spent money and all that, etc. Of course, you didn't touch upon, I didn't pursue also. You only when, how the IAS officer you perceive, that I think lately you did it little better. But could have been little explained actually. As you rightly pointed out yourself, I think your current affair is because not much was, whatever was little bit asked, better answer is, even though Aishwan also could be better. What he asked the question, probably as expected, probably you should be knowing really there.
Yes, sir.
But I mean definitely you can perform well,
yes, sir.
Prepare yourself properly actually.
Okay.
And don't commit such small mistake on etiquettes actually.
Yes,
that's important. Okay.
And, related to Air India, you were telling that disinvestment is a good way to bring back the, this could help, this could force you to enter into LIC also. So LIC is entering into the private and people investing in the things, could be prepared with the answer.
Yeah, actually, she LIC. Came, sorry to interrupt you, she came all the way to tell me to ask you about something on BSNL's parents.
Yeah.
This question was slightly different. That is totally also, I think, very negative impact will come. The moons have been given, Vodafone, Airtel, and you are not able to catch that point.
Airtel, recently there is an issue with regards to...
Vodafone AGR. Is actually, they have both have, is an only Supreme Court order.
Yes.
They have to pay. Vodafone is not in position to at all. Mm-hmm. I mean, that was such a current topic.
Okay.
You are telling something on your about backgrounds also on this thing. Okay.
Just one second.
Yes.
Doctor, you have trained as a dental surgeon, I guess, right? So you have a lot of experience which none of us make here. None of us have opened someone's mouth and performed something there, right?
Okay.
So, which means you have a huge amount of confidence within you, which of course reflects on your face. The intensity in your glance definitely shows that you have concentration.
Okay.
But perhaps some of the feedback which he has given, how you can inculcate in the coming days is that imagine when a patient comes to you and that patient is very nervous, how would you treat that person, right? You have to put that person into ease, right? So you will have your own ways of doing that by talking to him or by bringing yourself into a very relaxed state, right? So imagine that others are our patients and you are the dental surgeon. So perhaps, yeah, so that kind of a, you know, because you have the confidence, a little bit of a connect, a little bit of a relaxed connect can come. Perhaps you have to remember that you have an expertise which none of, perhaps most of the panel members wouldn't have, unless they are a dentist there.
Sorry, I think I just want to tell you one story, small story on this thing.
Yes, sure.
It's like you have to be careful also on this thing. One more doctor, we have mock interview, I don't.
I remember. I was there.
Maybe I think some other, you were not there. Actually, what was happened, did reasonably well. But was coming that, I mean, she was just like, whole interview was just like interacting with the patient. That sort of impression comes.
Oh.
You know, casualness comes. Or sometimes comes, like you said, why I thought I wish that this thing, you said because your doctor, good, you think of patient, because what happened, doctors sometimes very instructive actually. And they don't take the other views into the account.
That's the old view, because today's view in medical field, the patient is concerned as an informed patient. The old patriarchal view is that the patient is a stupid person, right? Not anymore. The patient is an informed patient. So I think you should consider, of course, the people sitting are informed patients.
Follow her advice, that they are informed patients. She did really well in the mock interview, only I think just by this thing, then everyone was telling them, probably I think, just take it off that, you don't know, I think she was a different, I mean, I'm not remembering which branch she was and all that. No, I think confidence level is really good in yours, it is not much problem and all that. You already analyze your weakness and all that. Only thing is that this sort of mistake, like coming and wishing, and giving a not lost look in the beginning and all that would be better for you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All the very best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
That will help when you think that others are patients. A patient comes, you don't look like that, right? You don't look like that. The patient will run away. You will lose your business, right? So you would rather develop a glance by which you will have the people sit and look to you.
Yes.
Depend on you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
All the best.
Thank you.